बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी सिंक्रोनस जनरेटर ऑपरेटिंग अलोन, लाइक सिंक्रोनस जनरेटर अलोन डिलीवरिंग पावर टू द लोड। द बिहेवियर ऑफ अ सिंक्रोनस जनरेटर अंडर लोड कंडीशंस वेरीज ग्रेटली डिपेंडिंग ऑन द पावर फैक्टर ऑफ द लोड। So the power factor of the load will vary. We can't control the power factor of the load. Power factor of the load will vary, so it changes some parameters of the synchronous generator. So then we control that parameters to maintain the behavior of a synchronous generator in a normal condition. And the behavior of synchronous generator also depends on whether the generator is operating alone or in parallel with some other synchronous generators. A single generator supplying the load. A diagram of a single generator supplying a load is shown in figure like this. So one generator, three phase supply to the load. So the load power factor will change, load value will change, IA current will change. So in this lecture we will study how generator parameters will act when the load changes. So an increase in the load will increase the real or reactive power drawn from the generator. So when load increases, current draw from the generator stator winding will increase, so IA will increase. But at the same time, the field current which is supplied from external DC supply will remain constant. When IF will remain constant, the flux which depends on IF, phi remains constant. When flux remains constant and the prime mover speed omega constant, so thus internal generated voltage EA is given as K phi omega, and these both terms are will remain constant, so EA will remain constant. When load increase, IA will increase, other things will remain constant. So if EA remains constant, then which thing will change when load increase? First one is the IA. As EA, we already studied that it is equal to V phase plus J of XS IA. So if this value increase and this will remain constant, so this whole value will increase, so as a result V phase decrease, so terminal voltage on the generator will decrease, which can be examined by this phasor diagram. I am going to draw it here. As we already studied this phasor diagram, if this is V phase and this is IA, so this is EA and this is, if RA is ignored, then this is J of XS IA. So let, if IA is increased, so magnitude of IA is like this, J of XS will increase but EA will remain constant. So V phase decrease. So this is J of XSIA dash, and this will be EA dash. So later EA magnitude is constant, the delta will change. First this delta, now this one delta, and now generator is delivering more power and the V phase decrease. Now suppose that the generator is loaded with unity power factor. In unity power factor, the phasor diagram looks like this, that IA is in phase with the V phase. So V phase decreases only slightly as shown in this phasor diagram. Similarly, for the leading loads, leading power factor, the V phase increases. Why? If new loads are added at the same power factor, this time the armature reaction voltage lies outside on this direction and V phase actually rises as shown in this phasor diagram. So the above term, above things can be generalized as that if lagging loads are added to a generator, V phase and the terminal voltage VT decreases significantly. If unity power factor are added to generator, there is slightly decrease in V phase and terminal voltage. But if leading loads are added to a generator, V phase and the terminal voltage will rise. And this thing normally happen in the power plant, that when the load are increases or decreasing, V terminal increases or decreases, and this can be balanced by changing the field current. And in the substation side, this can be managed by adding extra capacitors or adding the reactive power according to the load. So these three points are very important. So the next term to study in this lecture is voltage regulation. As you people already know about that, the voltage regulation can be defined as V no load minus V full load divided by V full load multiplied by 100. This voltage regulation we already study in the transformer. A synchronous generator operating at lagging power factor has positive voltage regulation. Same kind of behavior occur in the transformer we already study. A synchronous generator operating at unity power factor has a small positive voltage regulation, also positive but little bit less than the lagging power factor. Small positive VR. Same asynchronous generator operating at a leading power factor has a negative voltage regulation. The same kind of behavior occur in the transformer voltage regulation. In the leading power factor, load, the voltage regulation is negative. Negative VR. As we studied that in the lagging power factor load or lagging load, V phase decreases very sharply. So it is not desirable for our generator. We want to supply load at constant V phase. So how we can make this V phase constant? This V phase have to be made constant by increasing as EA is equal to V phase plus this or J of XSIA. This. If we increase this one, this will also increase. So how EA will increase? As we know that EA can be given as K phi omega. Speed is constant, this is constant, so we can this depends on IF. So if we increase the field current, phi will increase, and if phi will increase, EA will increase. And if EA will increase, the V phase at the terminal will increase. So for example, at no load, the V terminal is 480 volt. When we applied the lagging load on it, V terminal will become 440 volt. Now we increase the EA so that V phase again reach to 480 volt. So now we are supplying the load at constant voltage. This increase of IF according to the lagging load done by control system in the power system, in the power grounds. So this is the important thing, that how much IF you have to increase to maintain the V phase. The whole process can be described in general these four lines. First, decrease the field resistance in the generator increases its field current. First, increase field current, and increase in the field current increases the flux, and increases in the flux increases the internal generated EMF, and increase in EA increases V phase and the terminal voltage of the generator. But in case of leading load, as V phase already increased, for example, at this time V phase at no load is 480, when leading load will be applied, V phase will become increased, reach to 500 volt. Then in this case, we have to decrease EA to so that V phase again reduce to 440 volt. These values are just, I suppose, some examples for understanding. Now I am going to solve here example 5.2. Example 5.2 states that a 480 volt 60 hertz delta connected 4 pole synchronous generator has the open circuit characteristic as shown in figure. This is the open circuit characteristics. The generator has synchronous reactance. XS is 0.1 ohm and armature resistance is 0.015 ohm. You can see that XS is very high as compared to RA. At full load, the machine supplies IA is equal to 1200 ampere at 0.8 power factor lagging. Cos theta is equal to 0.8 lagging. Under full load conditions, the friction and windage losses are friction and windage losses are 40 kilowatt, and the core losses are 30 kilowatt. Ignore any field circuit loss. What is the speed of rotation of this generator? Number A is the speed of rotation. As for the speed of rotation, there is the famous formula, you already know about this. N is equal to 120 Fe over P. 120, 60 Hz, 4 pole, answer is 1800 revolutions per minute. Part B is how much field current must be supplied to the generator to make the terminal voltage 480 volt at no load. So part B, I have to calculate IF. As the machine is delta connected, so VT is equal to V phase, and at no load IA is zero. So if IA is zero, EA is equal to V phase. So EA is equal to V phase and V phase is equal to 480 volt. In return, IA will equal to 480 volt. So for checking IF, have to check the open circuit characteristics at 480 volt. From this graph, that 480 volt around about 4.5. Here IF is equal to 4.5. Now part C states that if the generator is now connected to a load and the load draws 1200 ampere at 0.8 power factor lagging, how much field current will be required to keep the terminal voltage equal to 480 volt. As the generator is delta connected, so IA 1200 divided by under root 3 is 692.8, and it is lagging, so lagging will be equal to minus 36.87 degree. From the equivalent circuit model of the synchronous generator which we already drive, EA will be equal to V phase plus IARA plus J of XS IA. V phase is equal to 480 volt, RA is this, IA is this, J of XS is 0.1, IA is this. By solving this, the EA value will become 532 angle 5.3 degree volt. So checking the IF, again we have to go towards the open circuit characteristics and check IF according to 532 volt. Approximately around volt here, and it will be greater than 5 like this, so it the field current is approximately 5.7. Now part D, how much power is the generator now supplying? How much power is supplied to the generator by the prime mover? What is the machine overall efficiency? The power that the generator is now supplying, P out electrical, can be found as under root 3 V terminal IL cos of theta, which will be equal to 798 kilowatt, and P in is equal to P out plus all losses, P copper loss, stator copper loss, plus core loss, plus friction and windage loss, plus stray loss. P copper loss is equal to 3 into IA square RA, so it is equal to 21.6 kilowatt. And other losses are given in the example, so P in is equal to 798 plus 21.6 plus 30 plus 40, so it is 889.6 kilowatt, and the overall efficiency is 789 multiplied by 100, it is 89.75%. So this is the efficiency of the generator. Now part E states that if the generator load were suddenly disconnected from the line, what would happen to its terminal voltage? If the load was suddenly disconnected, then the same V terminal will become equal to EA, and EA is 532 volt, so the same voltage will appear on the V terminal and 532 volt will appear on the V terminal. If the generator's load was suddenly disconnected from the line, the current IA would drop to zero, making EA is equal to V phase, and V terminal must rise to equal EA, and it is 532 volt. Similarly, now part F. Part F states that suppose that the generator is connected to a load drawing 1200 ampere at 0.8 power factor leading. How much field current would be required to keep V terminal at 480 volt? So in the leading load, we already studied that the V terminal will increase. So then IF have to be decreased and EA have to be decreased to maintain V terminal at 480 volt. We can see how. Same EA is equal to V phase. IARA G of XS. In this term will be positive because the current is leading, and the final EA value is 451 angle 7.1 degree. For checking the value of IF, have to be gone towards OCC. At 451 is approximately here, around about 4. So the field current would have to be adjusted to 4.1. So 4.1 ampere is have to be adjusted so that the V terminal should be equal to 480 volt. So now that's end from this lecture. Thank you.